'cause the time is right. Swing wide the doors to let in the light. Bring in the dawn for humankind. Swing wide the doors of this heart of mine. Swing wide the doors till the time is right. Swing wide the doors to let in the light. Bring in the dawn for humankind. Swing wide the doors of this heart of mine. I'm not holding it in anymore. I'm gonna shout it out loud. I understand now that I'm well informed and what this life is about. It's about love, it's about laughter, it's about comfort and smiles. It's about love, it's about kindness, it's about hearts open wide. It's about love, it's about fashion, it's about taking a chance. It's about love, it's about service, it's about lending a hand. About lending a hand. Wide the doors, the time is right. Swing wide the doors to let in the light. Bring in the dawn for humankind. Swing wide the doors of this heart of mine. There's a voice that I've heard for years. Learn to keep it inside. Well, now it's coming in loud and clear. I want a deeper light. Love, it's about laughter, it's about comfort and smiles. It's about love, it's about kindness, it's about hearts open wide. It's about love, it's about laughter, it's about comfort and smiles. It's about love, it's about kindness, it's about hearts open wide. It's about love, it's about laughter, it's about taking a chance. It's about love, it's about service, it's about lending a hand. Lending a hand. Swing wide the doors, the time is right. Swing wide the doors to let in the light. Bring in the dawn for humankind. Swing wide the doors of this heart of mine. Swing wide the doors of this heart of mine.
The doors are swung. Either online or in person, no matter where you are in this wonderful world of ours, and matter where you are on your wonderful spiritual path, we're so glad that your path has crossed ours this morning. And we would like to acknowledge that we are in the traditional and unceded territory of the Tsleil-Waututh people.
You're not on.
There's no switch on that one, though. That's a.
Yeah, it was on. Now it's on.
Okay. So we acknowledge that we are on the traditional and unceded territory of the Tsleil-Waututh Mestiimwaq here in Nanaimo, and we are grateful for that. We are committed to working together to a more just and honorable future and walking together as we move forward in life. And happy birthday, Reverend Thomas DeShooter. Yeah. And it is time for more music. And when Brian and I were planning our songs this morning, we thought the the focus for this week.
There we are.
The third week of Advent. We thought that was joy, so we planned some joy songs, and then Unity advised us that in Unity, this is the love week. So anyway, Brian's going to do a joy song for you now. Yes.
We
go
love
for
joy.
It.
We're joyous for love, yo.
Jeremiah was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine. Jeremiah was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine. I never understood a single word he said, but I helped him drink his wine. And he always had some mighty fine wine, singing joy to the world. All the boys and girls, joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea, joy to you and me. Well, if I was king of the world, tell you what I do. I throw away the cars and the bars and the wars. I make sweet love to you, singing joy to the world. All the boys and girls now, joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea. Joy to you and me. Spirit, I love to have my fun.
Hey.
I'm a high life flyer and a rainbow rider, sending love to everyone. Yeah, I'm a sending love to everyone. Singing joy to the world. All the boys and girls, joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea. Joy to you and me.
This one's about love.
Yeah. Well, I didn't hear it, so I started to doubt you. You couldn't feel it, so you just lost your way. And we'll never find it. Not love to you, give it away. Well, it's not a treasure you keep buried within you, and it's not a bankroll you save up for a rainy day. It's not like a lifeboat you don't use till you're sinking. It's not love to you. Give it away, so just give it away. Give it away. It's not love to you. Give it away, so just give it away. Give it away. It's not love. It's not peace till you make peace your mission, and it won't heal till they hear what you need to say. It's gonna take faith, 'cause it's such a contradiction. It's not love till you give it away, so just give it away.
We know that in order to be able to give love away, we need to accept love. And so we open ourselves now to self-love, to love for one another, and to the love of the infinite, which is all around us and within us. Unlimited in its love, unlimited in its power. And we bring into our conscious now our entire congregation, our board of directors, and our ministers, and lay leaders. And we know and affirm that we are surrounded in love, that we are filled with love, that we are
guided to make perfect loving choices and decisions. And with open hearts and minds, we know this to be true. We know our words to have power. And so we release all of these thoughts, these words, into the infinite law, which aligns behind our word and makes it so. And so it is. Good. Good. Thunder rumbles in the mountain passes, and lightning rattles the eaves of our houses. Flood waters await us in our avenues. Snow falls upon snow to avalanche over unprotected villages. The sky slips low and gray and threatening. We question ourselves. What have we done to so affront nature? We worry God. Are you there? Are you really there? Does the covenant you made with us still hold? Into this climate of fear and apprehension, Christmas enters, streaming lights of joy, ringing bells of hope, and singing carols of forgiveness high up in the bright air. The world is encouraged to come away from rancor. Come the way of friendship. It is the glad season. Thunder ebbs to silence and lightning sleeps quietly in the corner. Flood waters recede into memory. Snow becomes a yielding cushion to aid us as we make our way to higher ground. Hope is born again in the faces of children. It rides on the shoulders of our aged as they walk into their sunsets. Hope spreads around the earth, brightening all things, even hate, which crouches breeding in dark corridors. In our joy, we think we hear a whisper. At first, it is too soft, then only half heard. We listen carefully as it gathers strength. We hear a sweetness. The word is peace. It is loud now. It is louder, louder than the explosion of bombs. We tremble at the sound. We are thrilled by its presence. It is what we have hungered for. Not just the absence of war, but true peace, a harmony of spirit, a comfort of courtesy, security for our beloveds and their beloveds. We clap hands and welcome the peace of Christmas. We beckon this good season to wait a while with us. We, Baptist and Buddhist, Methodist and Muslim, say, come, peace. Come and fill us and our world with your majesty. We, the Jew and the Jainist, the Catholic and the Confucian, implore you to stay a while with us, so we may learn by your shimmering light how to look beyond complexion and see community. It is Christmas time. A halting of hate time. On this platform of peace, we can create a language to translate ourselves to ourselves and to each other. At this holy instant, we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ into the great religions of the world. We jubilate the precious advent of trust. We shout with glorious tongues at the coming of hope. All the earth's tribes loosen their voices to celebrate the promise of peace. We, angels and mortals, believers and non-believers, look heavenward and speak the word aloud. Peace. We look at our world and speak the word aloud. Peace. We look at each other, then into ourselves, and we say without shyness or apology or hesitation, peace, my brother. Peace, my sister. Peace, my soul.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place could be much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. The soul, though it's plain to see, this world is heavenly. Be God's glow. We could fly so high, let our spirit never die. In this heart I feel you are my brothers. Create a world with no fear. Together we'll hide happy tears. See this nation turned its swords into plowshares. We could really get there if we care enough for the living. Make a little space, make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place. For you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If we care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Heal the world, make it a better place. For you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If we care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. You and for me. You and for me. You and for me. You and for me.
Should I talk louder?
Yeah.
I'll use my inside voice.
It doesn't sound like your mic's on.
Yeah. No, it doesn't sound like your mic's on.
No, that might be me.
How about that?
It's your birthday.
Lights on.
Yeah, lights on. Lights on. Anyhow, we'll continue and we'll let our amazing crew back there figure out what needs to be figured out.
Meanwhile, I'll just talk
loud, as loud as I can. Or I could grab this mic here. Then I could be double mic'd. No? This mic doesn't? Okay. I'll borrow. I'll use Brian's mic. Oh, now. Wow. I can hear me too now. This is way better because there's a monitor here, so now I sound like I'm really big in the room and I have authority. Listen to me. All right. Sorry. I digress. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it's the B-Day today for myself. And there's a lot of great people that I share December as a birthday with. Lisa's birthday was just a couple of days ago. So there's you. There's one other great person.
Diane's brother, I believe.
Diane's daughter's birthday is today. Yeah. And Jesus' birthday is coming up in December, so there's that.
Right up there.
Really good.
Thomas.
No. I think that Michael Jackson song was the talk for today. That was quite long, that song. Anyhow, let's talk about love and the idea of love. And from a unity perspective, because, you know, if you're like me, you can get caught in the world of love as lust and that relationship and a relationship with other people based on, dare I use the word, sexual relationships. And I really think what unity was, the stand that Fillmore was making on love is about harmony, creating harmony. And so we can also have harmony with people, right? So let me just talk a little bit about that. I wrote this morning. I was thinking about this, and I wrote, living in harmony is an everyday, moment-by-moment practice. All wisdom teachings point out that all is readily available to us. There are always new opportunities to lean into a life of harmony, grace, and peace. So I really think we could try to live our lives with looking at, well, where could I create more harmony in my life? Where could I actually create harmony with others, with situations I'm in, with just how I do things? Like, for example, playing together as a band requires some harmony. And I'm not talking about the vocal harmonies. I'm just talking about all the working pieces. For us to sound like we're playing music, there's harmony that is happening with us. And I was watching So I got a, I'm finding lately when I come to do talks, I have a million ideas that are going through my brain. And so sometimes it's hard to kind of piece them together in a way that might make sense for everybody. So last night I was watching a movie, Priscilla Presley, that movie. And at the end of the movie is the Dolly Parton song, I Will Always Love You. Right, which is a great, in my opinion, a great song. The opening verse is, if I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go, but I know I'll think of you every step of the way. And it kind of rhymes with what Reverend Patricia was talking about, the idea that sometimes we need to let things go, that when in that song, it's the realization that I'm actually better off serving you by leaving the situation, that that would create more harmony, not only for the person leaving, but for the other person, seeing that in them, that this is actually the best choice. And as hard as that might be, because, you know, we get that emotional stuff going on within us as humans, it's really seeing that the best form of love here, the best form of harmonization, is to actually make a choice that might feel really uncomfortable in the moment. And as we've come up to this week to talk about love, which is what Unity is saying today is, of course, my birthday. Of course, love would be... We had the first week, the first Sunday was hope and faith, then peace, then love, and then joy. And yet, could we really have joy without love? So does it really matter whether today is love or joy? To me, they're kind of interchangeable experiences. When I am fully embracing joy in my world, then I truly also can experience that harmonizing flow of love in my life, of being able to experience everything as it's coming at me and also everything as I'm seeing it from the inside out, to just be in the experience of living in the moment and harmonizing myself with each moment. And imagine if we could do that. And I'm going to speak a little bit about that from two perspectives, because I've taken some pieces out of this, out of scripture, from Charles Fillmore and from the Upanishads. Anybody familiar with the Upanishads? Hindu, ancient Hindu text? Yeah, so I've got some stuff from that as well that I'd like to share. Fillmore said, love is the pure essence of being that binds together the whole human family. And it's that word bind that stuck out to me, because that to me symbolizes harmony. I can see that when we're truly bound together, there is a harmonizing shape to that. There's a harmonizing way of being together in that. And really, that's, for me, the goal is, how can I create that in my life? And I've actually got something that we're going to do as an exercise I'm going to share with you later that I've taken a long time to develop, and there's a bit of a comedy to that. But I was thinking also this morning of making croissants. Has anybody here ever made croissants? We have a few people here that have made that. I don't know if anybody out there. How'd it go? Not bad. How did your croissants go?
Really good, but I'm a baker, so.
Okay, so you know the effort that's involved in making croissants. So I went to, when I lived in Vancouver, I went to, there's a lovely French bakery down at Main and Broadway. And they had a Saturday where they were going to teach people to properly make croissants with butter and like right from scratch. And so I went, and it took 6 hours like to do this class. And the amount of times that you were required to roll the dough, right, and to blend in the butter, and all of the steps, like they gave me like a 5-page, you know, thing here on all the different steps with little photos of each step that were required. And I thought, this is great. I will never make these at home. There's no way. I even got one of those blender, you know, the proper yeah, the proper mix masters. I got one of those thinking, yeah, I'm going to make croissants. Then I went to this class. I'm not going to make croissants. I will harmonize with the not making of these. But I was thinking about that this morning in what is required to make them. And if the harmony is not in flow, they don't work. They just don't work. You could eat them, but they're not going to be that lovely, flaky piece of puff kind of pastry that is just full of butter and joy as you eat it. Yes, thank you. So not that croissants has anything to do with the Upanishads, but I want to bring that in because these are all the things I was thinking about this morning in thinking, how can I speak about love to people that have had their own experience with love and what it might mean to them? And so how can I impart something that might symbolize more of a unity foundation, which is this idea of harmony and the idea of the world working or not working and our relationship to the planet, whether it's working or not working at any given time, and how does that affect us? And so from the book, The Upanishads by Eknath Iswaran, who is considered, I think, the best at the actual translation to English on the Upanishads. The condensed meaning of the Upanishad itself, it rings, changes, or a simple household word, full, or parnam. In the inexhaustible reality, the infinite of that world, the unseen sends forth this world of infinite variety in which we live without ever being diminished. So we have this world of infinite variety. Would you agree with that? There's like so many possibilities at any given time that could take place. Even thinking about what were the chances that this reality that we have would actually have existed. If you just think of in terms of the Big Bang, all the things that were required for it to actually turn out the way it's turning out right now, where we're in this moment together experiencing whatever we're experiencing, the harmonization that had to work for all of that to unfold as we know it. The American poet Anne Sexton may have been thinking of this haunting invocation when she wrote, "Then the well spoke to me. It said, abundance is scooped from abundance, yet abundance remains." Yeah, just sit with that for a minute, maybe a day, a week, a month. Abundance is scooped from abundance, yet abundance remains. This idea that we have this ever-flowing energy of substance available to us, and that if we treat it with that kind of reverence, it will never diminish. It's ongoing. This is a very Gandhian idea. Materialism reinforces a paradigm of scarcity. There is not enough to go around, so we are doomed to fight one another for ever-diminishing resources. Spiritual economics begins not from the assumed scarcity of matter, but from the verifiable infinitude of consciousness. The verifiable infinitude of consciousness. So I think of that as we have the ability to consciously create, to think, to achieve greatness wherever we are, and to create harmony at our given choice. Any single time, we can choose that over something else, something that diminishes or takes away from somebody else. We could actually choose harmony. We can also choose, as you know, to win at any cost. Like in the competitive, if you're thinking of it in terms of the competitive world, there is that idea that my business, so if I take this to a business, having been a business owner for most of my life, if I take this to the business idea, I will win because I will crush my competition. Whereas in actual fact, you win by creating more people that are interested in building what you're building Therefore, it actually creates more want in the world for that, as opposed to having to crush something. Right? So in the competitive world, you could actually do away with that and think, no, I'm going to support the second and the third and the fourth and the fifth place in that same business and allow them to flourish, and then people will decide which they want most. So again, you're looking to create harmony, not crush others, right? Not have a fight, not have that friction. Think of this one original source. Plotinus said, as a spring, self-generating, feeding all of itself to the rivers, and yet not used up by them, ever at rest. When I heard that, I was thinking, like, yeah, the rivers keep flowing. The water just keeps circulating, and it's forever replenished. You know, all the water that's on planet Earth is the same amount of water that's always been here. It's never increased or decreased. It doesn't go anywhere. It doesn't leave and go into the atmosphere. All the same amount of moisture that is here has always been here and will always be here. It's just changed its shape at times. It goes through cycles, but it's the same amount that's always been here. As Gandhi put it, there is enough in the world for everyone's need. There is not enough for everyone's greed. Ooh, huh? I should have saved that right to the end. Mic drop. The appearance of scarcity overcomes those for whom, as the Upanishad says, the world without alone is real. So part of harmony is the ability to be with self, to not always need something from outside of you. That's why spirituality in my world is really an inside job. It's an inside out experience. It's what I've learned from Unity, is that it's here. The work is here. It's not working on others. It's not working on the world. It's actually not me going out and fighting for anything. It's me choosing how I'm going to show up in the world. And that is the leadership. It's you choosing that. Others then see, as I've shared, I think, on one of our podcasts with Patricia, when I saw Reverend Patricia, I was like, oh, I want what she has. How do I get that? Oh, I have to be a minister. Maybe not the best words to say to yourself. But for me, that's what it was going to take to do that level of deep work. So it starts with us, that we need to harmonize within ourselves. We need to create that harmony that's flowing within ourselves. And from there, then we can share that. You know, one of the things I say a lot on my Insight Timer talks is that I want to love so much that I can give it away, as the song we just sang, just give it away. Like, you have so, can you imagine you having so much love to give that you can just give it away? You don't need it from anybody. You don't need it from anything. There's nothing you're looking for out there. It's all self-generated and you can just give it. Imagine living your life that way. Not needing from anybody anything. Not even needing happy birthdays on your birthday. Just happy to be. I was so happy this morning that I got up and I could still breathe. I was like, wow, another win. Fooled somebody again, one more day. There is no scarcity of love, respect, meaning, the resources of consciousness. Such is the timeless wisdom of the Upanishads. There is no scarcity of love, respect, or meaning. So if there is no scarcity of that, why do we act like it's scarce? Why do we act like we can't get it or we can't find it? You know, we're meaning-making machines, right? So I really get that one. There's no scarcity of meaning. We make meaning out of everything. like it's raining on Tuesday at 11 o'clock. That must mean the bus is going to be late. No, seriously, that's, you know, we make meaning out of all sorts of things. We are meaning-making machines. So that, therefore, then, if we're that, we can make anything mean whatever we want it to mean. So again, it comes back to choosing. What am I going to choose to make this mean? So I'm going to share some slides with y'all. Yeah, I know. Oh, so I have Insight Timer on my phone. And I'm going to give you an exercise that took me. So I did this on the, so every day I go into Insight Timer to do my morning meditations. And there's the opportunity to check in. Now, they didn't always have that. They started that a few years after I was already using the app. But then, so now I check in because it kind of prompts me to check in. And I like to play the game of checking in. But for me in the beginning, it was just like, okay, how are you today? And I'm always, I have never been less than good. I wake up and I'm like, I'm good or I'm great. That's the standard way for me to wake up in the morning. Just the way I am, I think just comes from my dad. Just kind of push that, you know, kind of push that button for me all the time. Anyhow, so on this, the 823rd check-in that I completed, it was actually, I did this a couple days. So it took me, here's how slow I am, people. It took me 821 days to figure out how to really use this powerfully. I did it 820 times before the 821st time when I actually did it and went, oh, this could be really great in the morning. So here's what I discovered from it. And I'll pull it up on my phone here. Okay, so it says here, how do you feel, right? How are you today? So I hit great, and then the next option comes up. So it says, why do you feel great? Let's talk about that for a moment. So this is where you get to talk to yourself, right? This is harmonizing within yourself, actually looking at your life for a moment. So I used to go, this is like a family. Yeah, family's pretty good. Relationship, yeah, it's working. Yeah, friends. Oh, I got some good friends. Food, I could eat better. So maybe not checking that today. Health, yeah, I feel healthy. Exercise, oh, I didn't exercise. Not checking that. Spirituality, yeah, I'm pretty spiritual. Work, not sure if I'm loving work, and so I'll leave it. Studies, yep, I'm studying. Travel, no, I haven't traveled anywhere recently, so nope. Sleep, no, my sleep sucks. That's not working for me. Finances, yep, they're pretty good. Great, check those. And then I'd move to the next one. But don't move that slide yet. But here's what I discovered the other day, that I could actually take time. And I might go over on my talk time here, but just bear with me because I think it's worth sharing. So I actually stopped for a moment. I thought, well, what if I really did this? Like I was really checking in with myself. So I stopped and I was like, okay, family. Well, so I've got my wife, Leslie, and my two kids. Yep. They're great. I love them. They're awesome. I'm connected to them. Everything's working good. I've got my brothers and sisters. I got five brothers and sisters. So I started to image each one of them in my head. I could see each one of them, and then I could see their husbands and wives, and then I could see their kids. And I went through all of those, and I said their names very quickly to myself, but I went through all of their names, just kind of checking in with them, sending them out some, you know, some love, some appreciation, feeling the appreciation within me, like, wow, I get, look at all this family I have. This is amazing. So fantastic. And so then I hit family and it goes green. Okay, when you hit these, when you can check them off, they go green. So then I was like, great, relationship. Well, it doesn't say relationships, it says relationship. So this would be my one relationship of major importance in my life, my relationship with my wife. And I was thinking, yeah, my relationship, sure. We've had our struggles, we have our disagreements at time, but overall, man, 20 plus years together, it's all worked. We got great kids. Yes, I'm good with our relationship. And then I actually thought for a moment, you know what? I've had previous relationships. I know she doesn't think I did, but I did have relationships before Leslie. And I just had a brief moment where I threw them some respect and some appreciation for what I learned about myself from those relationships that didn't work out in the end. They were just a brief moment in time, but I think they helped build me to the person I am in this relationship. So I had some respect for that, and then I was able to hit relationship, go green. Yeah, that works. Friends, and then it was like, oh my gosh, friends, I have, like, there's my Being Man group that are I check in with every day. Of course, they're my friends. But then there's my Unity family that have become my friends. And I tried to vision everybody that I could possibly think of at Unity in my head really quickly, like all the relationships that I have now developed here and the support and love and appreciation I've received from them and I get to give out to them. Wow, I have so many friends. Damn it, I'm blessed. This is fantastic. Checked friends off. Next was food. And you know, I battle mentally with my quality of food choices at times, but I thought this morning, you know what? I'm going to just look at it and go, man, I have like, what, 20 grocery stores within 10 kilometers of my house or something to go get food from. How many people in the world don't have one? So then I was just kind of, whoa, had a whole different view of food and appreciation for the fact that I have an abundance of choice. And I actually have money to go into those stores and buy something. May not be the healthiest choice there, but man, I actually get to eat. Wow. Holy crap. How could I ever think other than greatness around the quality of food that I have a choice in? So check that one off, green. Then it was health, and it's like, oh, well, I've had back issues in my life from drumming and playing hockey, and you know, I got a bum knee, but really, at the end of the day, I'm a pretty healthy guy. So for me, great. But also what came up was the idea of thinking about this, well, in Unity speak, it's not just how I feel now, it's what am I calling myself into? Could I actually appreciate maybe the relationship that's coming, maybe the friends that I don't have yet but are coming, maybe the healthy lifestyle that I might not be living yet but I could be living into, maybe I could start appreciating that as well. And so although I don't make the healthiest choices all the time, I began to appreciate that there is a health for me that I can live into. And so, great, I got to check that. That was green. Then exercise, kind of the same thing. I don't exercise every day. How about anybody here? Do you exercise every day? Some people, yeah. I mean, hey, I could look at exercises. I rolled out of bed. I did a roll. Like, I did a roll out of bed. So I didn't just get up. I actually rolled out and stood up off of the ground. That's exercise. So I could sell myself on that. But what I'm really thinking about is, am I out there physically exercising? And it's like, yeah, I was on the trails. When I did this, I was standing on top of a cliff overlooking, you know, trees with Getty just looking at me like, what are you doing, man? I want to go. But I thought, I'm out exercising. I'm breathing in fresh air. I could check that off. Spirituality. Look at the work I was doing right now. I was like, man, I can check that off. That became green. Then work was like, oh, I don't really, I'm kind of this minister and I have this business. What am I doing with my work? I'm not really sure. Man, I have a choice. Holy smokes. Like, I actually get to choose what I want to do with my life. Wow, that's amazing. Check that off. Studies. I read, I listen to podcasts every day. Every day I am ingesting something towards what I want to do in the world and what I want to cause in the world. So I got to check that off. Then there was travels. Like, well, I haven't traveled for a while, so I guess I don't get to check that one off. And I thought, well, you know what? Like, for example, this morning, I rode my motorcycle here. That's travel by the very definition. I traveled, and I had a great time. I was riding my motorcycle. I know it was only like 5 minutes, but who cares? I had the wind. It was a great 5 minutes. Travel. Check that one off. Right. Woo. Sleep. Anybody here get up at 3 a.m. all the time? Yeah. Yeah, so I was battling with like, oh, I'm supposed to get 8 hours every night or you're gonna die early. Anybody read those articles? Yeah, I've read those articles, right? And I was like, so I was battling this, but I wake up and I feel rested. So is that a bad thing? No, so it must be okay. And you know what? I'm gonna take steps to make my sleep better. I'm gonna do a little research and find out maybe there's some things I can do in the evening before going to bed that will help me get into a more restful state. Then I was having this conversation with somebody and they said, you know, there's this, Hindu Eastern philosophy that 3 a.m. is like some kind of magical hour. I didn't research it. And so then I thought, oh, my sleep's awesome. I get up at 3 a.m. because I'm magically connected to this thing that somebody shared with me that I know nothing about, but I'll take it. Check that puppy off. Then finances was like food. It's like, am I the richest guy in the world? No. Do I need to be? No. Everything seems to be taken care of. I always have enough, which Leslie and I were talking this morning, the Rolling Stones song, you can't always get what you want, but you might find you get what you need. Everything just seems to show up for me. I'm a very lucky person in that regard. So I got to check that off. And then that brings us to the next slide, which is green. See, they were all green. Why do you feel great? I went through all of those. It's like, great. Then there's another slide. Feeling anything else? Oh, man, what? Now I got to go through this. Oh, well, okay, so I was, it's like, yeah, I didn't even make it home that day. I'm still out on the mountain. So then it was like, okay, blessed. Am I feeling blessed? Oh, man, after just going through that, how could I not feel blessed? Really? Like, if I understand the meaning of the word, I'm feeling pretty blessed. Next over was inspired. Am I feeling inspired? Yeah! I could take on the world right now. I dare anybody to try to knock me off this mountain. Ain't gonna happen. I am inspired. Happy. I don't really like the word happy. Kind of feels like it's, I don't know, what does that mean, really, happy? But I realized I'm happy. I got a smile from ear to ear, so I was able to check happy off and excited. Well, you can hear right, even just right now, I am pumped. I am excited for life. Man, I get to live this. This is grateful. Oh my gosh! How much great gratitude could I have other than doing this exercise and really getting real with myself about how much I can achieve in my life and how much I can call into my being and my awareness. Yeah, I'm grateful, and damn it, I feel confident. And hey, I'm spiritual, so I know I'm relaxed. Like, I know I'm excited and all that, but really in this moment, I'm truly relaxed about it too. There's no stress in me. Now, hopeful, I've never liked that word either. Hopeful just kind of seems like, I don't even know what that means, hopeful. But then a few days before I did this, I had listened to a gal who's a Tai Chi Chinese, traditional Chinese medicine doctor. And she did a whole talk on Instagram on hope. And hopefulness is actually, you can get stuck in hopeful, right, where nothing happens. But you need some hope in your life to call in to your presence that future that you want for yourself, which goes back to those ideas I shared earlier. Like, it might, my relationship might not be great now, or my food might not be great now, or my sleep might not be great now, but I can see what I want from that, so I can call that into my presence now, which is actually living with hopefulness. So I was able to check that off. So next slide. They're all green. And now you could start a journal entry, or you could just say, complete the check-in. And I completed my check-in. And then I walked home. But I kind of glided home. There was no way that I was like walking. Like, the guy that started in the morning that thought he was, you know, happy and joyful and feeling good, I couldn't even put into words how that felt. So now that I know this, it's like I need more time in the morning so I can go through this every single morning to get myself in a true state of love and harmony and appreciation. And that's what's available for us, right? We just have to choose it. No? Am I crazy on that? No? No? I could, well, I am. I could be crazy, but in a good way, yeah. Yeah. So the final thing I want to share, I think, is from 1 Corinthians, Paul's dedication to love. I'm not going to share the whole thing, but I'm going to just share the part 4-8. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. And so that, with that, I invite you to join me for a few moments of quiet time. And you can take into your quiet time whatever comes up for you right now. However you're feeling, whatever resonates. If you're comfortable, close your eyes. If not, maybe just find a spot on the floor or this chair in front of you to soften your gaze. And as you're ready, when you breathe in, you can open your eyes with your breath. Love never fails. Namaste.
Love is my decision. Up to me to give of my heart. Love is my decision. No one else can help me to start. And once I decide to change my mind, love will show me how. Love is my decision right here and now. Love is my decision. It's up to me to stand on that bridge. Love is my decision. No one else can make me forgive. And once I decide to change my mind, love will show me how. Love
decision, my decision, right here and now. Love is my decision. It's up to me to dance down that road. Love is my decision. No one else can lighten my load. And once I decide to change my mind, love will show me how. Love is my decision, right here and now.
It's only appropriate that we lay down a really, really, really funky happy birthday. Which also brings me joy, so. I'll play you in here.
So I don't know. Inside Timer's going to have to put up a new emotion that you can feel. It's what I'm feeling right now. Redundant. Wow. Wow. And I'm so grateful to be redundant.
Ah, yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. So coming up, we are sorry to advise that we have decided wisely, divinely guided, to not proceed with the purchase of the German Cultural Center. A very wise decision moving forward. Thank you, Spirit. And we know that our board is still considering and open to being guided. We affirm, we know divine order is at work in all our affairs. And Phoenix episode Rising, number 11, is with Elle this week. A very interesting listen. Thank you, Elle, for doing that. And a beautiful message from Reverend Vicky is also available on just, you know, all the links are in your newsletter, which comes out on Thursday, and which can also be found on the homepage of our webpage. So easy access to all these. And our podcast is now up and running for those of you who do Spotify and things like that. All of our sessions so far, the audio only is available, so you can listen in your car or while you're going to sleep. Afternoon Christmas candlelighting service in Victoria is Friday afternoon, December 22nd at the First Metropolitan Church. Sing along at 1 o'clock and 1:30 is the service. And they are continuing to collect things like socks and hats and mittens and things that can be given away. So if you're attending any of the events in Victoria, please take what you can. Christmas Carol, this Wednesday night. Three more sleeps. Brian and I, among others, will be entertaining you. Please realize that that time has crept up very quickly, and it's this week. You do not necessarily need a ticket. There should be lots of room for everyone, and there will be refreshments. Candlelighting service is next Sunday, oh my God, December 24th. That also will be up at Bethlehem Retreat Center. So please, this is a beautiful opportunity to invite people who may not be familiar with what Unity stands for. And the ongoing events, as usual, are all on our webpage. Note the change in time for the full moon circle. And bring in the kids. I think we do have a kid today. Yes. Probably been out there wondering, when am I coming in? Yes. Welcome, let us repeat our blessing to our child today. We see the divine light shining as you. We love and appreciate you exactly the way we are. And we love and appreciate our children's nurturers as well. Our vision, Unity Vancouver Island, is a growing, unfolding, expanding center of light and love, mighty to attract its good and radiate good to others. And Unity, worldwide mission is a world powerfully transformed by the growing movement of shared spiritual awakening. And I want to thank everyone here today, back there, everyone who participated in this service today, which was exceptional and outstanding. And I think Brian is going to express gratitude as well.
Sing along.
Say hello, Brian.
Hello, Brian.
Hello. Oh, I am so grateful for this life
I have to live. Oh, and I am so grateful for all I have to give. For I live in a world of abundance, in a true never-ending source from above. Yes, I live in a world of abundance, with a life overflowing and a heart full of love. I am so grateful, for I know my path is blessed by love, so full and graceful, I can trust in every step. For I live in a world of abundance, in a true never-ending source from above. Yes, I live in a world of abundance, with a life overflowing and a heart full of love. Yes, I live in a world of abundance, in a true never-ending source from above. Yes, I live in a world of abundance, with a life overflowing and a heart full of love.
Thank you, Brian. Thank you, music team. Thank you, all the assistants and Margaret on the camera. Margaret will also be in the prayer room for a few minutes after service today for individual support. So please join in our prayer for protection, following which we will close with a very special song. The light that is God surrounds us. We are one with the light. The love that is God folds us. We are one with the love. The power that is God protects us. We are one with the power. The presence that is God watches over us. We are one with the presence. Wherever we are, God is, and so it is. Amen.
On the first day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, on the second day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, love everyone and you need to forgive and release. On the third day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, cast out all fear, love everyone and you need to forgive and release. On the fourth day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the fifth day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, God's everywhere. Pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the sixth day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, look on the bright side, God's everywhere. Pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the seventh day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, always be thankful, look on the bright side, God's everywhere. Pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the eighth day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, know you're abundant, always be thankful, look on the bright side, God's everywhere. Pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the ninth day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, strive to be patient, know your abundance, always be thankful, look on the bright side, God's everywhere. Pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the tenth day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, try meditation, strive to be patient, know you're abundant, always be thankful, look on the bright side, God's everywhere. every day. Cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the 11th day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, help those who need it, try meditation, strive to be patient, know you're abundant, always be thankful, look on the bright side, God's everywhere. Pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. On the 12th day of Christmas, my spirit said to me, do affirmations, help those who need it, try meditation, strive to be patient, know you're abundant, always be thankful, look on the bright side, God's everywhere. Pray every day, cast out fear, love everyone, and you need to forgive and release. Merry Christmas, everyone.